I think everyone seems so interested, like, where you from, right here, exactly. Like, why Ghana?
Exactly.
You from because he wouldn't be arrested.
He will not be arrested, I'm telling you. It will be difficult. Like what happened to R. Kelly, for instance. It's not too much.
It's not even that. It's
not too much, but
it's the fact
for us, we feel it's bad because
that's not,
why would you
even
exactly?
That's a job.
That's a job. We are paying you for it, so
yeah.
Why take money from people?
Yeah.
Where we came, if you want to know, heavy duty chopper. Yeah.
It's really cool in here. It's like you can meet the locals
come
here. Exactly. It's just like
in the and the setting is not like this luxurious restaurant that you see around.
Yeah, no, it's like proper.
Yeah, exactly. Like, so I think that's basically what all of us came to meet. That's the name, chopper. Pineapple juice.
Yeah. You guys love ginger here,
right? We have ginger a lot. And pineapple definitely will be the ginger inside.
The fruit in Ghana is unnatural.
It's natural, like
it's so direct, nice.
Exactly. Direct from the ground. No additives, no GMOs. Nothing done.
Really, do you have dairy milk in Ghana?
Some people do it. But those people, most of them export those ones abroad, but the local ones that you will get from the people, there is no like GMO.
I think the quality of food that I've had in Ghana is a lot better than the UK.
Yeah, because
for
it's
sure.
Natural. The UK and the
for
US,
sure.
You know.
Yeah. And it's nice going to the markets and like
seeing them on
that
the ground.
That was also a big massive culture shock. You have to, there's a certain way to go into the market and talk to people about what you want. So you ask about prices, like is how much choose these prices.
And you can bargain.
Oh, you can bargain.
You have to bargain.
Yeah, because I always get the abroni prices. They see me coming.
Well, when they see you like that, that's
they
what
can they smell.
Exactly. That's why it is good when you come into the country, try to learn one or two phrases of the local dialect. That's a key language. That one, if you know how to speak it and speak it well, when you go to the market, okay, may talk pineapple. May, like when you say that meaning, may, I'm buying.
May talk.
Yeah, may talk.
Mm-hmm.
And may talk tomatoes. May talk pepper. May talk onions.
Mm-hmm.
If you don't know the local names for onions, like that one, at least you can say it in the English form.
Mm-hmm.
May talk like Jenny, may talk milk, may talk meat or something.
Mm-hmm.
But at least learn one or two phrases.
Yeah.
Immediately they hear that you are saying that, they will be like, hey, Obroni will catch you.
Yeah.
Obroni will catch you, but
even if I say Manasseh, they're like, oh.
Because they've clearly seen that you are not pronouncing the thing really well.
Yeah.
And easily they will know that you are not from here.
I mean, I look like I'm not from there anyway. It's not hard. Yeah.
Like for the looks, sometimes we have, like in Ghana, we have lots of people like you who are Ghanaians.
I haven't seen any.
They are.
They're there. What do you call them?
Sometimes they also get the same thing. But when they speak and
Ghanaians
get to know that
the
accent is really, really
there.
Yeah. This, for instance, like this food that we ate here, you can get a much more local. Not like much more. You can get this same setting, everything.
Yeah.
And their food is even cheaper than here.
I can see that because I feel like it's a
It is even a bit expensive because you see the place, it's very old.
It's central.
People know here. Okay.
It's quite big.
Exactly.
It's really big.
Oh, but some places are even bigger than this place.
Mm-hmm.
And those places, like when you go there, you buy your food like 3 CD. You buy your meat.
3 cities,
I'm telling you, and it's quite good.
Right? Yeah.
Yeah. There are places around. Yeah. You know, these kind of places, they know that they are very known, people know them, so they don't usually think about like they are selling this thing to like this particular set of people.
Demographic, yeah.
Exactly.
What are you planning?
Maybe next time I will just look for a much more local place that you can.
This is the local.
Like really local. Accra, okay, so we can get here, we can get some places. I think there are even one place around this area.
Mm-hmm. That's very local.
Yeah, like that's very local.
So do you think here people come here from, like, if they're working?
Yeah, people
come here for lots of time. Exactly. It's like filling to eat, but in the middle of the day.
You know, a normal Ghanaian would just wake up like the morning. Maybe they will take cocoa. Yep. Like cocoa is like a porridge.
Okay, they will have that.
Yeah, they will take that porridge. Then I think from there they wait around 11, 12 thereabout. They come and eat something. Then in the evening they can take something light. Let's say this killer willy that I was talking about. Someone can take that with a peanut and yeah.
I feel like that actually makes more sense to eat like that.
But some people too, I'm coming to the second one. Some people too in the morning.
Coming to the second one now.
Some people in the morning, they love to take pounds.
In the morning?
I'm telling you.
But I guess
it's
kind of like, it's a carb, isn't it? Like
those people, most of them, the kind of work that they do, if not this office work that you see around, they really do hard work.
Hard work, so they need the energy, right?
Exactly. So that's why most of them, they take bangku in the morning. You have to sustain them.
But just bangku with what? Something else?
Bangku with okra like this. Okra soup. Or we have bangku with grenade pepper,
okay,
together with tomatoes and onions. Then the tilapia or something. So that's.
I'm going to do that. Working hard,
so
you
can't
eat that much.
Exactly. Yeah. And just to sustain you and also get that energy to work more. Laughing and be very like being very happy, like
yeah.
You are trying to speak their language. You see that thing? Exactly.
They're like, oh poor thing, she's trying.
Exactly. So that's how it is. It's very good to learn the language.
Yeah.
Very, very, very good. Anywhere that you go.
So you have to.
You have to.
Yeah, that is an hour.
If you are not even going to be able to learn everything.
Yeah.
The one or two stuff that you can do. Or the like one or two phrases that you can learn just to buy stuff, greet people, and all that. Just learn those ones.
Yeah.
That is very good. You see that too. Metal is also like cheap, but that one, you know, the donation.
Yeah, I know.
Like, will tell what you really mean. Metal meaning I will buy. Metal, I'm buying.
Wow. That is funny. A very small distinction.
Exactly.
Okay, so
meto. Meto is combined.
Meto.
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 Kind of sounds Japanese.
Yeah, meto.
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 Maybe pineapple drink. So meto pineapple drink. Meto pineapple. Pineapple drink.
Meto.
Tomato. Yeah, tomato.
Meto. Water.
Water or something. You can say.
So when a woman.
But water is. Ensue.
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 N. N like N apostrophe S U O.
Ensue.
Ensue.
Ensue. Ensue.
The N. You just mentioned the N.
Ensue. Ensue.
That's water.
Look how long that took
you. That's water. And like what again? I want to look on names.
Names? Oh, of something.
Okay, this is who even brought us bowl. Usually we have something called earthenware bowl. I don't know why you say that. Earthenware bowl. No, that's English. Ethinwebo.
That's not English.
That's English. Ethin, like E-S-S-S.
E-A-R-T-H.
Ethin.
E-A-R-T-H.
Earth. Ethin. Word. Ethin word.
W-A-R-E.
W-A-R-E.
Earthenware bowl.
It's a bowl actually that we eat in, but it was made from clay.
Earth.
So that's what I'm trying to say.
Our
accents are different, so yeah, I understand you. Most times when you go to the local shop bars around or the eating place, like small restaurants that we have, that's what we eat mostly. I'm surprised these people don't have it.
So it looks like clay.
It's a clay, actually. That's what they use in doing that locally. Very nice, like most of the time when you go to every household in Ghana, it's there. That's what we eat, especially fufu.
Mm-hmm.
That's what we eat.
Is fufu eaten everywhere in Ghana, or is it in just like specific?
You know, the Ghanaian foods that we have, it's from like every tribe has their food.
Mm-hmm.
But in Ghana, because of how we live in this country, you will see everyone eating everything.
Yeah, fine. I see.
Fufu is from the Ashanti region.
Mm-hmm.
But when you come to Accra, mm-hmm. Accra, the people, like the indigenous are Ghana people. But most of them eat fufu.
Right.
When you talk about kenke, we have different types of kenke. We have the fancy kenke, we have the guard kenke, and some other kenke too.
Mm-hmm.
The guy can pay, you can go to Kumasi and you will see people selling it and Ashanti's buying.
So it's everywhere, it's got now.
Everybody's eating everywhere. When it comes to wachi.
Yeah.
Wachi and
what's that with the beans, right?
The beans and the rice, exactly.
Yeah.
Wachi.
I like that, that's nice.
Very nice. I've actually noticed that almost every foreigner that comes to Ghana loves
it. I think you like beans.
Okay.
I don't know why.
That's why. And rice too is very
common. Right. Maybe it's just more familiar.
Exactly,
so
that's why.
Yeah.
So, wachi for instance and koko is a food from my body, Muslims in Ghana. That's their dish.
Oh, really?
Exactly.
Oh.
In this country, when you are here, you will not even see whether we have Muslims or not.
Can I ask a question?
Yeah, you can.
So, I wasn't really expecting there to be, I don't know if this sounds very good enough, but I didn't know there would be loads of Muslims in the mosque. Like, I thought it was a very Christian country.
That is the thing, because sitting here, you can, there can be about 5 Muslims here, but you know, like, you don't see them unless they dress.
They dress, yeah.
Or they speak their language before you even know.
And it's
that's how Ghana is. Like, we are all united. Like, we are all together.
That's what I want to know. Is it exactly. Every, it's just like there's no tension between you.
No,
I love that. Thing. And that's one thing I've noticed. Like, I thought that was an analysis at all, but I didn't
know. I say the Muslims in Ghana are the coolest that you can find in the world. And I think it also boils down to how they've actually settled in Ghana, because they are not at a particular place and like one part of the country.
They're not just being settled.
They are everywhere.
They integrate in life.
Yeah. When you go to every town, every village in this country, there is something called Zongo.
Zongo.
That is like the place that you find most of the Muslims.
Okay.
And it's everywhere. Like Accra here, we have about, if I'm not mistaken, more than 10 Zongos in Accra. Muslim communities.
Okay, fine. So Muslim
communities. That's the name for it. Zongo. You will find not the, more than 10.
Yeah. So
Muslim
like,
communities.
Yeah.
We have Nima, we have Mamobi, we have Newtown, we have, there are plenty, I can't mention all. Medina is one, and a lot of places. So, it is very difficult
I
for you to even
see.
You will not see,
it's
you will not see whether.
And they probably know that I don't know.
But they are about 30%.
Oh, really? Yeah. No, I didn't know that.
That's one thing actually that makes this country very unique.
Yeah, and it's nice. I like the fact that it's so people all together.
Everybody.
Even in England, it's
very,
it's
unfortunate.
Extremely. So it's nice to see that here.
Yeah.
Like,
here in Atlanta.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, it's. Once in a while, you hear one or two stuffs in the Zongos. It's not even that, like, all the time. Like,
yeah.
You don't find that all the time.
What do you think is, like, the people that have been here, foreigners coming? Because I want to see if people welcome people coming here, or is there, like, a resentment?
Let me bring it here. In Ghana, I have not traveled to many countries, but I can boldly say that Ghanaians are the, maybe, I will not say the only, but one of the countries that welcome foreigners like more than any other country. They love foreigners. This country. This country. This country love foreigners, like, I don't know why, but we just love foreigners.
I felt that, like, being a foreigner, just very welcome.
Like,
yeah.
In this
I think everyone's also interested, like, where are you from, why are you here,
exactly.
What are you doing? Like, why Ghana? Ah.
Exactly. because some Ghanaians are moving out from here to abroad.
Yeah.
All because
they feel the West is better.
The country is here, like, the country is not treating them well.
Mm-hmm.
The West is better,
yeah.
And all that, so they are moving there. But I always say in this country, if you don't have money, that's when you feel the country is treating you bad.
1,000%.
Exactly. But if you have money,
yeah,
it is the best place that you can ever be.
That's, I honestly feel like that.
Best place that you can ever be. Ghana.
I literally feel, there's so many times that I'm maybe in a taxi or walking down the road or I'm talking to someone,
yeah,
and I'm just like, I just take it in and I'm just, the energy is good.
Yeah.
I'm just like, I love God. Like, and I have multiple moments like that.
2019, when people started coming in, most of the, there is one African American that, he's a YouTuber. He was like, on his channel, he was assessing all the countries that he has traveled to. And it's like, Ghana is beautiful. It's
too free.
Too free, like the freedom here is too much.
It's ridiculous. The freedom is insane.
The freedom is too much. Too much. And even we as Ghanaians, sometimes we say
it. Yeah, it's too
because
free.
We feel like sometimes the rules are there, the laws are there, but enforcing it.
It's too free. And that's it.
Is the problem. You know, so people just.
Yeah. They kind of just do what they want.
Do what they want.
And that can be unless good and bad.
And bad. Yeah. See that. Now sometimes when you do that and for instance, like how do I even put it? Like sometimes when you do it and it goes to the extreme, that one the government will not or the police will not like forgive you on that one.
So what do you mean by extreme?
I want to give an example. Something should come in my mind. I'm trying to remember something. Okay, I think there is sometimes you see artists in this country and actors and actresses sometimes some of them misbehave on social media.
Okay.
Exposing themselves. Just doing some bad stuff. And you will be there, you will feel the country is free, so you can do. And social media is a different world on its own. You will do it, but it can get to the extreme. For example, a lady in Ghana stripped herself naked in front of her child, like this, facing each other.
No.
They took a picture together and she posted on social media. You see, she has been exposing, but not too much.
That's so much.
But she did it too much. And that
that's
one.
Like child abuse. It's weird.
They arrested her, took her to court.
Yeah, but that's actually illegal. That's too far.
Exactly.
That's,
so you can do
you
the
mean.
Thing. Exactly. You can do the thing, but
just
when
don't
it,
film
it goes to it goes to the extreme. You can do this thing in your house, room, but not on social media.
Yeah.
You are someone, a public figure that people follow you. People learn from you. So what are you trying?
No.
She has been released because of a child. Because no one was there to cater for the child, so I think they used that,
they balanced that argument
as a base to ask for a bill. But she was actually in prison for like a month, but she did not spend 3 months or so. I think 3 months, but she did not spend the 3 months. Or I think she spent about a month or so
and
she was
in prison. Yeah. But
so that is too extreme. Too extreme.
Don't you take it too far.
Why, like...
I don't know why you would think to do that in the first place. I don't know
in front
where.
Of the child.
I think you've got to be... Okay, I don't want to say anything. I don't want to say anything. I'll give my answer.
So, these things happen. So in Ghana, like people say, you would think the laws don't work because someone has done something and the person has not been arrested. Maybe you will do it. And you will be arrested.
Yeah, so it's not consistent.
Consistency is not there. And especially.
It doesn't matter like who you are. That's the
and when it, that's where I'm coming at. Coming to. When it gets to maybe this person is part of this government, or know someone in this government, or know someone here or there, it will be difficult for them to arrest such a person. You understand? That's like it actually cuts across in Africa.
I think it is very common in Africa, definitely.
It cuts across.
It's just is that corruption, I guess it is.
Imagine we Elon Musk is from Ghana.
I didn't say that again.
Elon Musk.
Oh right.
Is from Ghana. No one would dare.
Yeah,
even if
true.
He misbehaves or does something wrong, no one would dare. But let him do something in America, right? Something wrong.
Yeah.
You'll be arrested straight.
Attacked.
Exactly. But here, they'll just leave you. Oh, he's a rich man. He has done this, he has done that.
I think it depends what the crime is, though. Like in the US.
In the US.
Like, I think it depends what the crime is.
On the crime too.
Yeah, like okay. If it was against women or something.
No, that one, yeah, I know that they will arrest you immediately. When it comes to women, they will arrest you immediately. Even in Ghana, that thing, if the person reports
it. So let's say, like, all of us were
in Ghana. In Ghana.
And all of these women came out and said, who's raping, who's done this. He still wouldn't be arrested.
He will not be arrested, I'm telling you. It will be difficult. Like what happened to R. Kelly, for instance.
That would not happen.
It will be difficult. They will even try to.
Because why is that though? It's because he carries too much power.
Exactly. And the people in power, definitely, if he's in Ghana, for instance,
yes.
He will one way or the other sponsor some of the politicians. Their campaign. You see that thing? So it will be difficult for them to do what? Okay, someone who funds our party, we should arrest him.
Oh no.
They will never do that. Never. It will never happen. So that's how Africa is. That's how Africa is.
Exactly. Oh no.
That would never happen. That would never happen.
I hear you.
Exactly.
But I still feel like maybe it's not as an extreme thing, isn't it? I just feel like there is still corruption in that sense. I just don't think it's obvious.
Like the corruption?
Yeah, like it's not.
No, the corruption is there.
The corruption is definitely there.
It's there, but you will not see it like
it's
in your
blatant.
Face.
It's not so blatant.
Yeah, in your face like this. I think, hey, Ghanaians, please forgive me for saying this, but I think the one that you will see like in your face like this is maybe the police. Yeah, for them.
I mean, I've already experienced.
Ah, okay. Then I'm not even.
No,
the police.
Yeah.
They want something small.
Always.
Yeah. For them.
They're just looking for something.
And there are some institutions. If the work that you do, you are supposed to work in hand with this. Some of these institutions in Ghana, you will experience that one too, because that worker there or that government worker there. Feels he's being paid at the end of the month, but he also feels you coming to him for him to do something for you at the office. At least you need to do what?
He should be getting paid for it.
Something like just give him a tip. We don't even.
So really, so if I'm going to the police, that's actually just more etiquette for me to just give.
Exactly.
How much?
It depends. It's kind of, like it's something that I would say it should come from your heart.
Okay.
Yeah, they are not going to charge you like pay this amount.
Well, what is a disrespectful amount?
Like what is the disrespect?
Disrespectful amount. Like if I was thinking that this is worth it. Okay, fine. Okay. Oh, it's not the worst.
It's not too much.
It's not even nice.
It's not too much, but
it's the fact
like
that
for us, we feel. It's bad because
that's not,
why would you
even
exactly?
That's a job.
That's a job. We are paying you for it, so
yeah.
Why take money from people?
Yeah.
But people who suffer that like these things most is the truck drivers. Mm-hmm. Those small buses that you see them around shouting,
yeah.
Madina,
all.
Yeah, La Paz, all these guys. They are the people that suffer these things most.
In what sense?
Because most of them too, most of the times, they break rules. A place that you are not supposed to park and take passengers, they will just park there. Immediately you do that, the police will come, like if they see you, they will arrest you. And when they arrest you too, it's either they take you to the station for you to pay a bigger amount,
yeah.
Or give you something small so that you just leave you. You see that? Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So they always have to
pay something. And even sometimes you are not even supposed to pay anything. Maybe it's a checkpoint or something. When you get there, you need to give them something. You've not committed any crime. But
you just
it's like it has actually become a norm.
So I should give.
You, for instance, when you are driving in a private car, for instance, you can just go. It's just once in a while that the police will stop you and be like, they will start talking to you, and even you can tell from the whatever you're saying that they want something. So when that thing happens, and you feel like giving them food,
just give it to them.
You can just give them something. That's all.
Just, that's already happened.
Yeah. So that's the thing.
And then introduced to the Ghana Museum.
So, Ghana here.
Yeah. I can definitely see.